We're on the west shore of Cedar Lake.
Learning all about a new citizen science project from the U called Cover It Up. Mike, tell us about the scope of the project. What's going on with it?
The problem with buckthorn is that it takes over forests, understories, excludes native species, and makes forests less valuable for humans and wildlife. You remove it, but it comes back pretty quickly thereafter. We're looking at interrupting that cycle by introducing native plants to soak up the space that buckthorn would otherwise occupy, including things like wild rye, which are grasses, wildflowers like black-eyed Susan, and then we also use shrubs like elderberry or trees like sugar maple.
What are we looking at in terms of this project over here? What's going on?
So this is one of our citizen science plots. We have a series of six squares here. They're each 5 feet by 5 feet, and within each of those squares, we're asking them to seed half of them with a seed mix that we've designed in order to provide a dense cover that's going to potentially shade out buckthorn and keep it from establishing in the long run.
We're still accepting people into the project. We're looking to really get people from, you know, all areas of the state. We know buckthorn occurs from all the way from northern Minnesota to southern Minnesota. The participants in the project are currently removing buckthorn from their property. In the springtime, they will actually go out and set up their experiment, just as you can see in the background here. And from there, they'll have 3 years where they'll actually monitor and collect observations about what they're seeing, how is buckthorn doing, how are the plants doing on the site.
There's three requirements to get involved with the Cover It Up project: have buckthorn around, in a wooded area, and in Minnesota.
So if you've ever wanted to be a scientist, now's your chance.
Thank you, Bobby. You can learn more about the project on care11.com. Just click on Features, then Grow with Care.